A, you're killing yourself. B, you are not functioning at your peak. You may have adapted and feel like you're functioning at your peak, but if your peak is here and you're getting 4 to 6 hours of sleep a night, you're only functioning here and you're creating brain damage. Brain damage. The most important thing you can do, we talk about diet and exercise and reducing stress, very important. If you're not getting good quality sleep, that shit goes out the window. Doesn't matter. You basically cancel it out. And that's the thing is we are stretching so hard to get more things done that not only are we not sleeping the number of hours, but even people who are sleeping, 7 to 8 hours are getting very often getting really poor quality sleep. So not deep sleep. And we got, here's the other thing, which I just think this
By the
is.
way, for all I know, obesity, 30% of us are morbidly obese, affects your sleep.
Well, and vice versa, sleep deprivation affects obesity because it changes your metabolism.
15 years ago, no one knew what a sleep study was.
Right.
Now everyone's taking sleep studies. I've got sleep apnea. Why is that? And we're snoring more than any time we ever have, and that could be like sleep apnea. It's really good.
Yeah, no, I just I always tell people this, and I am somebody who doesn't get enough sleep. I don't get enough sleep.
How much sleep do you get? When do you go to bed? Do you have a set time you go to bed?
Yeah, every single night. Now, which
What time do you go
also
to
is
bed?
because I struggled with insomnia for years. I had a hard time, like for 20 years, I struggled with insomnia. So once I got over that, oh, and by the way, about 90% of our sleep problems, I can't fall asleep, I can't stay asleep, that kind of stuff, 90% of those have to do with either behaviors or lifestyle stuff, not an underlying medical condition. Only about 10% of people who have a sleep problem have some sort of medical condition driving it. Most
Well,
of it, yeah,
most
most
I
of
know
it
is.
is we're either jacked up on caffeine, we have poor sleep patterns where we're changing the times that we go to sleep each night, we're taking naps, we're using technology so that we're using so much technology. This is a huge problem. We're using so much technology that we feel tired. And I don't know how many of us have been through this. You feel tired. You're like, oh, it's not even time to go to bed. You go to bed, and then boing, you're wide awake
Yep.
because your sleep center has not been triggered. There's a sleep switch that has to be turned. This is really interesting, very counterintuitive. We have a inside our brain, there's a sleep switch. That switch, I'm oversimplifying it, has to be turned on to fall asleep.
Okay.
You would think it's the other way around, like
Yep.
nights out, lights out. And when your brain has been engaged for so long, you still can feel exhausted, but your brain does not trigger the sleep switch to start putting you to sleep.
Yeah.
And so basic things, on average, I don't care who you are, 8 hours of sleep a night. Don't the six, I only need 5 to 6 hours.
Yeah.
Bullshit.
Yeah.